Blackstone Audiobooks presents Flowering Wilderness by John Galsworthy. Dedication to Herman Auld. Chapter 1. Shortly after the appearance of the Budget in 1930, the eighth wonder of the world might have been observed in the neighbourhood of Victoria Station. Three English people of wholly different type engaged in contemplating simultaneously a London statue. They'd come separately, and stood a little apart from each other in the southwest corner of the open space clear of the trees, where the drifting late afternoon light of spring was not in their eyes. One of these three was a young woman of about 26, one a youngish man of perhaps 34, and one a man of between 50 and 60. The young woman, slender and far from stupid-looking, had her head tilted slightly upward to one side, and a faint smile on her parted lips. The younger man, who wore a blue overcoat, with a belt girt tightly round his thin middle, as if he felt the spring wind chilly, was sallow from sunburn, and the rather disdainful look of his mouth was being curiously contradicted by eyes fixed on the statue with real intensity of feeling. The elder man, very tall, in a brown suit and brown buckskin shoes, lounged with his hands in his trousers pockets, and his long, weathered, good-looking face masked in a sort of shrewd scepticism. In the meantime, the statue, which was that of Marshal Foch on his horse, stood high up among those trees, stiller than any of them. The youngish man spoke suddenly. "He delivered us." The effect of this breach of form on the others was diverse. The elder man's eyebrows went slightly up, and he moved forward as if to examine the horse's legs. The young woman turned and looked frankly at the speaker, and instantly her face became surprised. "Aren't you Wilfrid Desert?" The youngish man bowed. "Then," said the young woman, "we've met at Fleur Mont's wedding. You were best man, if you remember, the first I'd seen. I was only 16. You wouldn't remember me. Dinny Cheryl baptized Elizabeth. They ran me in for bridesmaid at the last minute." The youngish man's mouth lost its disdain. "I remember your hair perfectly." "Nobody ever remembers me by anything else." "Wrong. I remember thinking you'd sat to Botticelli. You're still sitting, I see." Dinny was thinking. His eyes were the first to flutter me, and they really are beautiful. The said eyes had been turned again upon the statue. "He did deliver us," said Desert.
"You were there, of course."
"Flying, and fed up to the teeth."
"Do you like the statue?"
"The horse?"
"Yes," murmured Dinny. "It is a horse, not just a prancing barrel, with teeth, nostrils, and an arch."
"The whole thing's workmanlike, like Foch himself."
Dinny wrinkled her brow. "I like the way it stands up quietly among those trees."
"How is Michael? You're a cousin of his, if I remember."
"Michael's all right. Still in the house. He has a seat he simply can't lose."
"And Fleur?"
"Flourishing. Did you know she had a daughter last year?"
"Fleur? That makes two, doesn't it?"
"Yes, they call this one Catherine."
"I haven't been home since 1927. Gosh, it's a long time since that wedding."
"You look," said Dinny, contemplating the sallow darkness of his face, "as if you'd been in the sun."
"When I'm not in the sun, I'm not alive."
"Michael once told me you lived in the East."
"Well, I wander about there."
His face seemed to darken still more, and he gave a little shiver.
"Beastly cold, the English spring."
"And do you still write poetry?"
"Oh, you know of that weakness."
"I've read them all. I like the last volume best."
He grinned. "Thank you for stroking me the right way. Poets, you know, like it. Who's that tall man? I seem to know his face."
The tall man who had moved to the other side of the statue was coming back. Somehow, murmured Dinny, I connect him with that wedding too.
The tall man came up to them. The Hawks aren't all that, he said.
Dinny smiled. I always feel so thankful I haven't got Hawks. We were just trying to decide whether we knew you. Weren't you at Michael Mont's wedding some years ago?
I was. And who are you, young lady?
We all met there. I'm his first cousin on his mother's side, Dinny Cheryl. Mr. Desert was his best man.
The tall man nodded. Oh, ah, my name's Jack Muscombe. I'm a first cousin of his father's.
He turned to Desert.
You admired Fosh, it seems.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.